lush jungles threaded by underground rivers.
We're tubing in the Mayan underworld, Xobagua.
And coastlined with white sand beaches, in Belize, nature reigns supreme, with amazing creatures both on land.
There's two baby monkeys. Adorable.
And in the sea. You can feel the rich culture of the Garifuna people on the coast.
Use your whole finger, right? But you don't make sure that you hear it. Hang out of it.
And imagine historical adventure in the jungles.
These are the needles that are used for blow darts.
You guys ready for an unbelievable day?
Join us as we explore it all in
Travel Kids Belize!
I'm Nathan.
And I'm Seamus.
And we're Mom and Dad.
We're traveling around the world discovering amazing countries, new cultures, and really wild experiences together.
Come along with us as we learn all about our planet and about being together as a family.
As we discover the wonders of the world, the wonders of nature, and sometimes wonder, what were we thinking in Travel with Kids? Located along the Caribbean coast of Central America, bordered by Mexico to the north and Guatemala to the west, Belize is a small country with a landmass smaller than that of the U.S. state of Massachusetts. Thousands of years ago, at the height of the Mayan Empire, hundreds of thousands of people lived here at the several huge Mayan cities, including Xunantunich, Lamanai, and Caracol. Today, Belize has a Caribbean vibe, especially in the beach cities like Placencia, where Garifuna villages celebrate their African roots. They trace their ancestry to slave ships that had been shipwrecked, and they were set free.
Slaves on the ship had came on the island, and they full up the island. So the Caribs, which dwell there, and the Arawaks, they were overpowered. And when the British came, they wanted land to plant it, sugar, and but the Garifuna people were rebels, so they didn't give up their land.
They take great pride in the fact that they took a stand against the British, even if they were defeated.
Remains that survived, they are the one that still here in Belize, keeping the culture alive.
For this part of the trip, it's really Travel with Kids. Lots of them. We're joined by our guest host, Phoebe, Parker, Nick, Ben, and Lauren. We're heading out from the jungle after 3 nights at Chalk Creek Lodge, and Placencia is just where we're headed. Placencia is a tiny town, so we must go by small plane. And with our big group of guest hosts, kids, and families, the plane is all ours. After driving from the interior at Chalk Creek back to Belize City, we catch our flight to Placencia. And we're ready for the beach. The flight from Belize City to Placencia is only about half an hour, and the views are amazing. And the kids are fascinated traveling in such a small plane. They make Phoebe the official co-pilot. Did I say we took up every seat on the flight? Even to the point that our co-captain and stewardess is a 10-year-old.
From all of us at Maya Island Air, would like to thank you for flying with us and have a nice day.
Ikumbu intombi yami, igamala yomthola ngelema. Ikumbu intombi yami, emadoda nje igamala yomthola ngelema.
After claiming our bags, we hop in a van and drive all of about 2 minutes to our hotel, where we are greeted with cool washcloths and tropical drinks.
Woo! Oh, yeah.
We are staying at Chabalma Resort.
Lauren, look at the pool.
Its spacious villas with kitchen and living area are perfect for families with plenty of room for the whole family to have some private space. The beachfront pools are great for relaxing, and as soon as we get there, the kids head straight for the water. They have a blast taking out the resort's kayaks and jumping off the docks into the ocean. After cooling off, we decide to head into town to explore. The nice thing about Chabal Mar is its excellent proximity to town. You can walk, but the resort also has bikes to lend and a shuttle. Golf carts are also a popular mode of transportation around town and can be rented from the resort.
Originally a fishing village, Plasencia is located on an 8-mile peninsula, which is less than a quarter mile wide in some places. To the west of the peninsula is a vast lagoon, surrounded by mangroves and jungle, and frequented by manatees. The east of the Plasencia is lined with white sand beaches, keys, and the azure waters of the Caribbean Sea. At the tip of the peninsula is Plasencia Town, which is where we're headed. And we've deemed this Pirate Night as tribute to the Caribbean's rich pirate history. The small town has one road and lots of pedestrian walkways lined with restaurants and shops. The kids have fun playing with local kids and acting like pirates. Out on the beach, we meet a local named Carl from the nearby Garifuna village, Seen Bite. He shows us how to crack a coconut, local style.
Hunger Games! Fight for the coconut!
Carl shows the kids how to crack the coconut.
It's 1, 2, 3.
Guess they still have some learning to do on island living, but he gives them a taste anyway.
A coconut. The inside of a coconut. It's so good.
And where do pirates hide their treasure? In caves, and Belize is filled with them. So today we're heading inland to check it out. We head up the highway to meet David from Cave Tubing RS for a trip through the Caves Branch River system. A small sign reading Jaguar Paw indicates the turn. Easy to miss, so keep an eye out. We actually took a wrong turn down the Hummingbird Highway, so look out for this sign and turn down the dirt road. And after about 20 minutes bumping down the road, we find the entrance to Nahoch Chen Caves Branch Archaeological Reserve. David's enthusiasm for the area is instantly apparent.
Guys are ready for Fear Factor. We're gonna do the vegetarian. I brought a couple of my guys with me. I brought a herbalist. We're gonna eat some vegetables.
Nice.
We're gonna eat some living things like we're on Subway. You guys ready for an unbelievable day?
Yeah!
All right, let's get the party started.
I can't believe it.
You can't believe it? Let's get it started, guys. In what we call present-day Belize, there was over a million Mayans living here. And they used to live in our jungle. And they learned to use different type of vegetation, different type of leaves to do different type of stuff. Like this, is called the ink tree. And let me see the back of your hand.
Can you put it on?
Yeah, definitely.
W.
And you squeeze on it, brings out the highlighter.
We start out hiking through the jungle, where the guides point out all sorts of cool stuff, like leaves that close when you touch them.
When you touch it, the leaves fall off.
Wow, so weird.
He shows them plants that were used for different purposes, like weapons.
This tree right here would have been their weapon of choice. It's called a prick yellow tree. And basically you take it, you'll carve it like a bat, dip it into some poison, and whack you with it.
These are the needles that are used for blow darts.
And for something a bit more personal, he sure read his audience right on that one.
Toilet paper. Touch. No, grab onto it.
Fuzzy,
soft. Nice and quilty. We call this bush charmin. Pass it around, guys. It's quilted.
The jungle here has been providing for people for thousands of years. Not only does it provide weapons and utensils, but it nurtures with food.
Summertime is fruit time. That's when we have over 20 different species of mangoes. We have different other species of oranges, papayas, crabu, kenips. All tropical fruits that are indigenous of Belize. Look at the... And as you can see from my friend here, some of them have an acquired taste. Close it in the bark. If you love a sour plum, you're gonna love the taste of this. Here, peel it off.
And just eat it?
Oh, and yeah. Just eat it and swallow.
Sour plum.
It's like right sour there. Plum. And basically this will be a substitute for like a hydration salt. It's good?
When we come to a river crossing, David tells them to jump in and cool off. And as with everything in Belize, this jump has adventure written all over it. After the river, David has another local favorite for the kids to try, bugs.
This is your ultimate source of protein. They're called peppermint termites. So you basically scratch into it like an anteater bear would, and they're gonna come and I wanna defend my castle.
Look here, guys.
Who's gonna, look, you just grab one.
Yeah. Oh, God.
Here, grab one, just grab one, see? Mmm, pepperminty. No aftertaste, nothing poisonous. Get your proteins.
And they don't taste like anything. Take one. Oh, they do taste like it.
The peanuts and peppermint together?
They do taste like it.
Just grab one. You gotta grab one.
See this?
Then you lick it.
When the world comes to an end and you don't have any protein or food, come to here. Perfect source of protein. You have one right here.
Got a little something.
That's called a sapodilla tree. And basically, you get a guy with a big belt, throw it around that tree, climb up the tree, put X's in the bark, put a big metal pot to the bottom, and it gathers the sap. The sap, in its natural state, has no smell, has no taste. Add flavoring, add sugar, you get chicle. And the guys who would harvest it would call them chicleros.
At the top of the hill, we come to a clearing and the river flowing about 30 feet below. We descend into the canyon and enter the caves.
We're tubing in the Mayan underworld called Xobalba.
A place the ancient Mayans thought was ruled by the dark gods. And we are greeted by a creepy omen. A sign of a turbulent journey ahead? As we enter the first cave, bats lurk in the dark cracks in the ceiling. We pass through shafts of light, piercing the darkness. It feels like something straight from an Indiana Jones movie. Suddenly, the current picks up, and we hear thundering ahead. A waterfall? Maybe the underworld is intent on taking us after all. It is a waterfall, but it's off to the side. And makes a beautiful sight to see. And the kids have fun splashing through it. But alas, no pirate bounty here. All in all, our jungle hike and cave journey was an amazing day, and we say goodbye to our awesome guides and head back to the beach.
We are lured back to the coast by the drumming of the Garifuna people. Carl, one of the locals we met in town last night, invited us to join him in his village, Senbite, where he says the Garifuna culture is alive and well.
Today we're still keeping the culture alive with the different rhythms of the Garifuna drums. And the music is originated from Africa, West Africa. And it started in St. Vincent, that's the original home for the Garifuna people.
Its African origins are evident, but there's definitely a Caribbean soul in it.
We have like 6 different rhythms, which we mostly play. The original is Punta, and it's the most popular dance of the Garifuna people. Then we have the Hogo Hogo, which we started with always. That's a chanting and involving the singing of sacred songs. You know, then we have Jan Kunu, which the kids was dancing earlier.
And after a short performance,
our name is Owaragone. That's the name of our group. And we are located in St. Vite Village, Belize. Right next or behind Burns Kitchen.
We have Alex,
playing the turtle shell, Master Drummer on the lead drum, and Handsome, aka Weebot, playing the lead drum.
Under a house where the locals gather most days to play together, including an amazing performance by a small child the kids nickname Little Drummer Boy. He offers the kids a chance to try their own hand at it. Handsome gives them a quick lesson.
Which hand do you use most?
Is it only these two fingers?
No, you can use your whole finger, right? But you just make sure that you hear the hang out of it. Yeah.
But it's a hard rhythm to master. Handsome reminds them to slow down. And feel the rhythm.
Heartbeat first.
And they start to get the hang of it. The boys do get a good feel for Garifuna culture and enjoy getting to know the community.
We end our evening back in town where the kids meet up with their new Belizean friends. We stumble across a fun restaurant, the Pickled Parrot, where a playground next door entertains the kids. And the restaurant owner's dog is a big hit.
This dog has three legs and we're gonna show him how to catch a stick. Here we go. I don't think he wants to. Woo! I'm gonna try really high.
Oh! Evening times at outdoor Caribbean restaurants are always great fun for families. Many even have playgrounds on premise or nearby. And the relaxed open air atmosphere is fun for meeting all kinds of people.
What's your name?
What's your name?
Jonathan.
Oh, you can totally touch his beak and he won't do anything.
Today we're heading out on the water with Avedon Divers Belize to some of the distant keys to check out the treasure below the surface in Belize. Belize has done an amazing job protecting its natural gems, with about 30% of the country listed as protected and almost 20 marine preserves.
Marine Reserve is the second largest marine reserve in Belize.
Exploring the water by snorkeling is fun, but for even more of an adventure, try scuba diving.
We're going to go on a dive together. Everyone's about to learn how to scuba dive.
Kids can get certified to dive at the age of 10, but even for those that are not certified, there are opportunities to try it out. Neither family we're traveling with are certified, so their diving today is part of a Discover Scuba course. Remember, if you do want to try diving, you can't dive 24 hours before a flight, so plan accordingly. And if you want to get certified while you're on vacation, you can do all the coursework ahead of time, leaving you more time to dive while you're on vacation.
This little diagram shows the different airspaces that we have to be worried about. One is the airspace in our lung, the most important one. Then we also have some in the air and sinuses. You will need to blow gently against a pinched nostril.
True.
That's true, very good. If you have a discomfort in your air or sinuses during descent, you should continue downwards. That's false.
So we're in that shallow water, we'll of course look over all the skills that we'll be practicing in shallow water before we move out into deeper water for your actual dive.
So we head out into shoulder deep water and descend to work on skills and finish with a short contained dive for a look around. After that, it's time for lunch and playtime. Then it's on the boat for more dive time.
Boat's finally learned and we're ready to go down the path. It's homework time.
Giant strides into the water lead us to a descent of about 30 feet to view amazing coral, colorful fish, but the most amazing thing is watching the group floating along, enjoying the experience together.
The dive today was a big hit, especially with the kids. But scuba diving can wear you out. Everyone's plenty tired and a couple painful ears. So we celebrate our dive back in Placencia Town with an early dinner at Secret Garden Restaurant. And next door, some gelato.
Doesn't taste like the home one. It tastes so much better. It tastes real.
On our last day, we decide to head by boat along the coast and inland to see if we can find some of the amazing creatures that all of that Belize protected area protects. We're exploring with Monkey River Eco Tours, who picks us up at the dock at our hotel. They're taking us up Monkey River to look for, you guessed it, monkeys. But there is lots to see along the way.
We'll be looking for birds, crocodiles, iguanas, and different wildlife that we encounter to go along our path itself, along the river.
And even before we get to the river, the kids spot animals.
Dolphins.
Along the river, he stops to get a close-up look at an iguana. And birds.
Whoa.
Whoa!
Those are birds now?
That's a bullet tree.
I remember that.
And to taste some of the jungle goodies.
Sugar cane, and it tastes like sugar. And then it's like juicy.
And it's good for you. It's my dream.
After about 45 minutes on the boat, we pull up to a bank.
I feel like we're gonna run into a wall.
To hike into the jungle to look for monkeys. But we don't have to hike very far.
Right there.
Yeah. Oh my God.
The guide tells us a little bit about the monkeys as we follow them through the jungle. And then more monkeys join them.
Whoa, there is one right there.
Oh, he's a big one. Look at him.
There's a howler monkey right there.
And these are called
the black howler monkeys. They call the howlers because it has that hypo bone inside the throat that amplifies the song, so it acts like a resonating chamber.
The baby's eating.
He's eating leaves.
These monkeys feed strictly on leaves and fruits. It has a territory of over 2 miles in span. It has one alpha male or one dominant male that takes them around the territory.
So. Yeah, he's gonna come see us.
I see his face. Look.
He's probably going, look at those people. They're right there.
The kids love watching them climb, swing, and jump through the trees.
Their feet are just
right
like
above
this.
Us. There's one right there,
too. That baby monkey is just holding on with his tail.
There's two baby monkeys. Adorable.
It's crazy how that little monkey can make so much noise.
How do they climb stuff? Like, the only difference between us and them are they have a tail.
Yeah,
and they're hairy.
Fingers are longer.
And they get a lesson in anatomy.
Oh, keep some nail too.
Put some hose on.
And they find out how the monkeys mark their territory. Ugh.
Oh, they're leaving.
That couldn't have been any better. We just saw monkeys right off the path. The boat pulled in. Four monkeys, mom, dad, two little babies.
This is awesome. It's turning awesome right here.
And we're back to the riverbank with all the animals checked off our list. Except one. But no sweat, because just downstream...
Here he comes. He's underwater.
Okay, no one fall in.
They come
no one fall.
Wait, we need some food.
It turns out to be an amazing day on the river, and as we weave back through the mangrove tunnels and across the lagoon, manatees pop their heads up to bid us goodbye.
These were the West Indian manatee itself, the same species you get all the way up to Florida. So the manatees are strictly herbivorous. Turtle grass is what they feed on.
Today it's time to say goodbye to our friends who are heading home by plane.
So we're provisioning our sailboat. We're taking a sailboat from Belize to Honduras, and we're in the store provisioning it.
For we're saying goodbye to Belize as well. So after stocking up at the local grocery store in Plasencia with some foods from home,
we got some pickles, pineapple slices, cheese and crackers, some snacks,
and some Belizean favorites.
Just beware, gave my tongue a sunburn. Then the only thing I have to beware is no wimps allowed. Bye.
You can't leave Belize without at least trying Marie Sharp's hot sauce. Or coming home with a couple jars of it. It's time to board the boat we chartered. You can charter boats all over the Caribbean. We found this one through the tourist office here. We meet the captain and the first mate, and we're setting off for Honduras.
Heading over to Honduras.
As we head out in the harbor, the captain gives us the itinerary for the next few days.
Straight out through Ranguana Passage, and then veer about 10, 15 degrees south, and then we'll stay on that heading until we get outside of Utila.
So we're going southeast.
And shows the kids how the steering works.
That's so weird.
So it's got a chain here that goes down to a motor, and that allows it, the motor to turn the wheel.
We watch as the depth drops off and we head out into the open ocean for our overnight sail. Two dolphins swim beside the boat as if saying goodbye. As we watch the dolphins jumping and playing at the bow, and Belize fading away in the background, I think about what an amazing experience with nature we had here in Belize, and what fun it was to share it with friends. And I look toward the horizon, in Honduras, and wonder what our next adventure will be.